Power Hour Prophetic Encounter Teleconference. Created by Minister Joyce and Prophet Moses Solomon. Join us every Thursday night at 9:15 p.m. to 10:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Call us at 1-402-237-6749. Use code 30515#. Join us as we encounter the prophetic hour.
That needs to release, amen. That you need to release, amen. We're opening the floor. If you need to release the word that the Lord has given you, it's going to help somebody, amen. So you can release at this time. Just announce yourself.
Well, praise God. This is Pastor Dunbar. Praise God. I stand in agreement totally with what Prophet Brandon just said and with what the other prophets said and the prophet before her. God is so awesome. I'm talking about God is awesome. And even when they were saying about praying, how God is desiring us to lay before him even more, I stand in total agreement with that, because I'm telling you, God is waking me up all time of night. I'm talking about 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock, just to get before him. And God, he is really, really moving upon his people. And God been impressing in my spirit the greater works that he is calling us to. I mean, we will be doing greater works, the greater works that he spoke about in his word. God is getting ready to manifest such awesome power in the lives of his saints, the ones that seeking him. I'm talking about diligently seeking God. God is getting ready to manifest his anointing like never before in the lives of his saints. I'm talking about prophets and prophetess is going to speak the word of God, and it's going to be like, it's going to be like an explosion going to take place in the spirit in people's lives. God is going to cause things to shift and turn around quickly in the lives of the people, and they receive the word of God. God, this thing has been so heavy on me for the past week, that how he's going to call, God, he's calling his people to do greater works. The same things that happened in the Bible, the same miracles, the same things that Jesus done. I mean, he is going to call us to do greater works. I'm telling you, he is pouring out his anointing like never before. But he wants the saints of God to be real. God put in my spirit, tell people your testimony. Don't hold back. Don't sugarcoat nothing. The people is coming in the church now, and they're looking for people that can be real with them, that can be raw, that can tell them that they done been through something. We wear our suits. We dress up when we come in the house of God. People look at us and they feel like, well, they ain't went through nothing. They don't know what I've been through. They won't even understand what I did. People got to be able to trust the God on the inside of you, knowing that you done been through something maybe way greater than what they have been through. We need to tell our testimony, tell the real story of our testimony. That is, that people can get delivered and set free.
Amen.
I'm telling you, God is moving right now in such a way. That I'm talking about, it's going to totally destroy yokes and bondages off of people's lives. I'm telling you, God is really, he is really pulling on his people. He is pulling on them. The ones that want more of him, he is giving himself to them. And I just praise God tonight, saints. I tell you, God had me on fire since I came out of the hospital. But I just praise and thank God for what he is doing in the lives of his people, because we haven't seen anything yet. I'm telling you, the first shall be last, and the last is going to be first. God is pushing people out on the forefront.
Amen.
That he knows that he can trust to get the job done.
Amen. Amen.
Praise God.
Amen. Do you have a testimony about your experience with in the hospital?
Oh God. I was so sick when I went in the hospital. I mean, I couldn't hold anything on my stomach. I couldn't even hold water. If I drank water, it came back up. They hooked me up to an IV to keep me, because I was so dehydrated, and I still was throwing up. I'm talking about, but I just kept seeking God and kept praying. I called prophets and prophetess before I even went in the hospital. I couldn't even say too much on the phone. All I could tell them was pray, because I didn't even know what was going on. But before I got sick, let me tell you how God will bring things back to you to let you know that you've been in a battle. Before I got sick, I had to went to visit my daughter and did spiritual warfare on where my daughter lived, because my daughter been going through some stuff. I'm talking about praying, and couldn't even sleep for praying, and just praying and binding and loosening. And when I came back home, I'm telling you, God, y'all, God is awesome. God let me knew that when I went in, I wasn't even covered. Let me tell you, the enemy, he wants to steal, kill, and destroy us, because he know that we can do damage. And when he know that you can do damage, he is going to do whatever he can to take you down. But you got to be strong enough to know how to stand and stand on his word and call those things that be not as though they were. And I'm telling you, God brought everything back to me. And let me know, this is going to pass. This is going to pass. All you got to do is just keep trusting me. You watch. This is going to pass. Every test that they did came back negative.
Mm-hmm.
Every test. They ran test after test after test. Every test came back negative. And so the doctor's report, because they want to give you a report when they can't find nothing. He said, well, I feel like stress is what caused this. I said, okay. I said, well, that's your opinion. You know, that's the diagnosis that you want to speak. I said, well, God, I'm not even receiving it, because I'm walking in my healing. But God is awesome. I thank God for every test for coming back negative. I thank God for how he brought me up out of that hospital. They wanted to keep me longer, but I told them if they didn't discharge me, I was going to discharge myself. Because
Amen.
I wasn't staying up in there not another day.
That's right.
So the doctor went ahead and discharged me. He said because if he didn't do it, the insurance wasn't going to pay if I would have walked out. So I told him, I said, I got to go. So he went ahead and discharged me. But I thank and praise God that I do walk in my healing. I know where my healing virtue comes from. And I stand in it, and I'm going to declare what God put in me to declare his word and let people know that they ain't got to do nothing but trust him. Rely on him. Give it all to him, because there is nothing impossible with God. Nothing. There's not a situation that will come up in your life. There is nothing that will come up against you that God ain't strong enough to handle it.
That's right. Hallelujah.
Because he is the one that created us.
Glory be to God.
And we belong to him.
That's it. We belong to him. Hallelujah.
So I thank God for what he is doing in my life. I thank God for how I feel in him. And I thank God that he's given me the strength to decree and declare his name. And thus saith the Lord. And I praise God today, saints, that I'm upon this line. I thank God for praying people. All you got to do is make a phone call and touch and agree with the saints of God, people who you know that love God and lean on their face before God. So I thank and praise God today for being on this line, and I just give God all the glory, the honor, and the praise for everything that he is doing among each and every one of you, because you have not even seen what God is getting ready to do. All I can tell you is to expect and be prepared, because God is getting ready to blow the sinks of God's mind.
Yeah, God. Hallelujah. Get ready, get ready, get ready, get ready, get ready. Hallelujah. He's going to lead. Amen. We are in the hour of trust now. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We have faith. We believe and we have the faith. Amen. But we're in the hour of trust now.
Amen.
We have seen
praise
the
God.
Things manifested. Can huh. we yet trust God? Can,
yes.
we, can we still trust him?
Huh.
He's going to do
Jesus.
What he said
Jesus.
He's going to do. Hallelujah.
Jesus.
We're in the hour of trust now.
Yes.
Hold on to your trust. Trust in
yes.
God. Hallelujah.
Yes.
And we just praise God for the testimony. And,
yes.
And we could feel the struggle and the pain that Pastor Dunbar was going through, but we got the unit on top of that and interceded for her. Amen.
Yes.
We even called the conference line from the hospital bed. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Time that night. Amen. The enemy tried to block it, stop it every which
mm.
way he could.
We
rose above all that.
Amen.
We rose above it. Amen.
That's right. That's
Amen.
Right. And you know, prophetess, I heard this man of God say this, and I tell you, it blessed my soul, saints of God. He said, you know, he said, how many of you watch the Morning Show? And he said, you know, the people that comes on there, half of them don't know who the baby father is. He said, but don't y'all know that we are blessed? That we know who our father is?
Mm-hmm.
And he don't even pay child support.
Mm-hmm.
And we all belong to him.
All belong.
Isn't that a blessing? That we can call on our daddy anytime we get ready.
Hallelujah.
Any time of night. Through any situation. We can Lord. Call on our daddy. And he loves all of us. Has no respect of persons.
Thank you, Jesus.
Love every last one of us. And he don't even have to pay out money for us. That's a blessing.
It is.
That's a blessing.
Hallelujah.
And I mean,
Hallelujah.
Each one of us can call him at the same time, and he still know each one of us individually.
Hallelujah. Glory.
An awesome God.
Yes, yes, yes.
An awesome God. I praise
Hallelujah.
God. I'm, oh, God, I thank you tonight, Lord. I thank you.
Thank you, Jesus. Amen.